Down beside the sea. Folkestone and its lift. Towards the end of the Victorian age, leisure activities changed. Hot summers and busy, overcrowded industrial cities created an interest in getting out of the towns and visiting the seaside. However, leisure habits were still very largely class divided, and not everyone could afford or have the time to go to the seaside. It was still only for the elite and the rich. The hotel was a landmark in the growth of the seaside resorts. Hotels became more and more popular for short and weekend visits, attractive due to their wide range of facilities, such as restaurants, smoking rooms, and public rooms where self-important people could parade themselves. Going to the seaside was said to be good for your health. Doctors, medics, and physicians all commended bathing as good for the skin and bones. Drinking seawater was also seen as a universal cure.
Dear Daisy, the sea is lovely here, only very wet and cold. Can you recognise me in the water? The weather has turned out grand. I'm just off out again. Kathleen.
Everyone delights to spend their summer all the day down beside the side of the silvery sea. I'm no exception to the rule, in fact, you like my way. I preside by the side of the silvery sea.
Folkestone enjoyed a surge in the number of holidaymakers to its newly built hotels and guest houses. However, here in Folkestone, it was difficult for people to get down from the hotel on the Lees, the clifftop walkway, to the attractions of the beach, the pier and the seafront. It was even more difficult to get back up again for the old, the sick and the faint-hearted. A solution to this problem came in the form of the first Lees Lift. A group of local businessmen formed the Folkestone Lift Company and leased land from Lord Radnor. And the lift was constructed by R.G. Waygood and officially opened on the 21st of September 1885 at a cost of £3,000. The track was some 164 feet long and operated using gravity. The brake, operated by the brakeman, was opened to allow water to flow into the tank under the carriage at the top. As soon as the weight of the upper carriage exceeded that of the lower, it started to move and the brake was applied to shut the water flow off. When the heavier carriage reaches the bottom, the water was released into the bottom reservoir, then recycled, being pumped back to the top for the next time. Other lifts were built on other sites in Folkestone, but none as successful as the first, and by the end of the World Wars, all of those had closed. Folkestone's heyday was over as a popular seaside resort. Holidays abroad were now the thing, and crowds dwindled. In 1967, the Folkestone Lift Company went into voluntary liquidation, and Folkestone Borough Council stepped in to run the operation, followed by Shepway District Council, as the boroughs merged. But when the lease ran out in 2009, the council deemed it too expensive to continue to operate. A public campaign ensued, and another company was formed, this time a non-profit-making organisation, working on behalf of the community to operate the lift. The Folkestone Lees Lift Community Interest Company was now successfully set up to run the lift, a thriving enterprise run by volunteers. It is a living museum and holds a unique place in the heritage of the town. As well as revenue from the paying passengers, money is raised for the upkeep from the sale of souvenirs and English Heritage Open Days, when visits to the pump room raise awareness of the history of the place and the desire to preserve it. Lively beer festivals have taken place in the lower station, bringing visitors and serving beers and ciders from microbreweries all over Kent. One of the carriages has even housed a triennial soundwork by Martin Creed, composed specifically for the Lees Lift. As the mechanism began to roll, so did the sound, attuned to the ascent and the descent, entitled Peace for String Quartet and Elevator. It brought a smile and total dismay in equal measure from those riding the lift.
It's an artwork. An artwork by Martin Creed, an artwork.
The lift is a remarkable piece of engineering that has carried more than 50 million people since it opened, in a process that is extremely energy efficient, that emits no pollution, recycles 100% of the water it uses to drive the cars and has a very small carbon footprint. Long may it continue to lift us up in Folkestone.